Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I've got for you the most amazing and extremely moist and dense chocolate cake. It is so soft and chocolatey and definitely one of my favorite cakes. Clearly, it's loaded with a lot of chocolate chips, but secretly, it's loaded with a vegetable called zucchini. And I don't know if you like it or not, but you're definitely gonna love it. This cake is insane. Just look at that beautiful slice. A cup of coffee with it and you're in heaven. This is honestly one of the best chocolate cakes I have ever eaten. Try it out and let's see what you think. So without wasting any more time, let's get started with this double chocolate zucchini cake. Firstly, I'm gonna prepare a flax egg. I'm using 1 tablespoon of flaxseed powder and to this I'm gonna add 3 tablespoons of water. If you don't mind using eggs, you can simply skip this step and add 1 egg to the recipe. Flaxseed powder is simply ground flax seeds. You can get them from any store nearby. I'm gonna give it a mix and let it sit for about 10 to 15 minutes till it becomes gelatin-like texture or egg white-like texture. In another bowl, I'm gonna take 1/4 cup of milk. This milk should not be cold and should not be very hot also. It should be like room temperature or slightly warm. To this, I'm adding 1 teaspoon of vinegar and I'm gonna give it a mix and set it aside. And now comes our secret ingredient, which is zucchini. You can use it in pastas or pizzas or sandwiches also, but making a cake is my favorite way of using it. I'm gonna cut the ends and I'm gonna peel it so that we are left with nice and soft zucchini. So now zucchini is actually tasteless. It has no taste of its own, but it has a lot of moisture. And we're gonna grate it to release all that moisture. I know it's not very fine, but once the cake is done, you won't even notice it's there. You cannot taste it in the cake. You won't even feel it's there. It's like a magical ingredient, giving our cake a lot of moisture and just disappearing. Now I'm gonna take 1 cup. This is a measuring cup and you cannot take any other cup. I'm gonna squeeze the zucchini gently. You don't have to squeeze it a lot because we need all that moisture. And I'm gonna fill it in the cup. Zucchinis are of different sizes. Once I made this cake with 1 zucchini and today I had to do it with 1.5. So it depends on the size of the zucchini. You basically need 1 full heaped cup of zucchini. But this is not done yet. I'm gonna press it and squeeze it into the cup. And you can see that there is still some space left in the cup. And I'm gonna fill it with more zucchini. I know it feels weird using a vegetable in a cake, but once you make it, there's no going back. You're gonna fall in love with this. So once the cup is full and no more zucchini can be added, you can keep this aside and we can start preparing our batter. Remember the milk and vinegar mixture that we kept aside? Look at this now. The milk has curdled and it has become buttermilk. To this, I'm adding 1/3 cup of oil. Any neutral flavored oil works. To this, I'm adding 1 teaspoon of coffee. This is optional but preferable. Then add 1/2 cup of sugar. I'm using breakfast sugar because it dissolves easily. Then add about a teaspoon of some good quality vanilla. Finally, add 1/4 teaspoon of salt. Now the salt and coffee don't provide any flavor but intensify the flavor of chocolate to a great extent. So your cake will be so much better if you add both of these ingredients. Give the mixture a nice mix until everything is dissolved. Remember the flax egg that we made? It has become egg white-like texture and now is the time to add it. If you don't mind using eggs, you can add 1 egg at this stage. If you don't have flax seeds, you can add 4 tablespoons of mashed banana, but that will change the flavor of the cake slightly. Now give everything a mix. And if you're using coffee, it's better if you use powdered coffee or maybe slightly dissolve the coffee in about a teaspoon of water or milk before adding it. Now is the time to add in our dry ingredients. Add 1 cup plus 1/3 cup of plain flour, which is maida. To this, add 1 tablespoon of corn flour. This is optional, but it will make your cake very soft. Now I'm adding 1/2 cup of dark cocoa. This is unsweetened, not the Hershey's and Cadbury's one that we get. Now to raise our cake, I'm gonna add 1 teaspoon of baking powder and 1 teaspoon of baking soda. The cake batter is really thick and heavy, so it needs a lot of raising agents to rise properly. Now I'm gonna sift everything together. This will not only remove all the lumps, but also make our cake lighter. You might have to use a spoon at last to remove all the lumps from the cocoa powder. And it's done. I'm gonna take a spatula and I'm gonna mix everything well. Also, did you notice that I made this cake using 1 bowl only? So you won't have to wash a lot of dishes after this. You can eat this cake any time of the day. And in my opinion, all that added zucchini makes it a perfect option for breakfast too. The batter will look really thick right now because all that moisture has not been added. So let's do that and add in our full cup of zucchini. Mix everything together using a spatula, making sure not to overmix the batter. Like most of us here, I'm a chocolate lover and I don't eat any other flavor in cakes unless I really have to. And take it from me, this is the best chocolate cake you'll ever eat. Even the non-chocolate lovers will love it. And all that zucchini makes it healthy anyway, am I right? Of course I am. So our batter is almost done, it looks nice, and now is the time to add in my favorite ingredient. You can skip it, but it just makes the cake so much better. I'm talking about chocolate chips. I'm gonna add 1/3 cup of chocolate chips and I'm gonna mix it well. If you want to justify to the name double chocolate zucchini cake, you will have to add these because these are the double to our chocolate. And there's never too much chocolate anyway. I'm gonna prove it to you in a while. The batter is done and now I'm gonna pour it into a rectangular mold. This is, I guess, 3:8. You can pour it in any 5 or 6 inch mold. So all that zucchini in the batter makes it really heavy and the batter doesn't flow off. So I'm gonna fill it almost up to the top. It won't flow out and our cake becomes perfectly domed. Now the final touch, adding some more chocolate chips because obviously the more the better. Does this make it a triple chocolate zucchini cake? Let me know in the comments if you think so. It's time to bake it at 180 degrees Celsius in a preheated oven for about 40 to 45 minutes or until a toothpick comes out clean. And look at that gorgeous cake. It's so beautiful. Love the cracks on top. Let it cool completely before demolding it because it'll be very soft and it might break. And our double or maybe triple, you'll have to decide. Chocolate zucchini cake is ready and now I'm gonna dig in. The cake looks amazing. Be sure to let it chill before you cut it because otherwise it'll crumble all over. I'm using a serrated knife to cut it because it doesn't ruin the texture and keeps it intact. Slicing a cake has to be one of my favorite parts of making a cake. Eating it obviously remains on top. And look at that beautiful slice. The texture is so soft and tender, super moist and yummy. The crust is slightly crispy, just like you get in the edge piece of a brownie. And I am definitely a fan. The choco chips that we added inside the batter not only provide taste, but also provide a lot of fudginess to the cake. This cake will become your favorite in no time. And now is my favorite part. I have a lot of favorite parts actually. I love the whole process of making a cake, but anyway, look at that slice, it's so soft. I just want to take a bite right away. If you haven't tried it yet, you guys are missing out on a lot. Trust me, you have to try it. Like, this is the best chocolate cake ever. Eat it as it is, or if you want to take it up to another level, drizzle some salted caramel sauce and what do I say? I can't even tell you. You'll have to try it yourself to find out. And if you do try it out, please share your reviews with us in the comment section. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't and press the bell icon so that you never miss any video. I'll see you next time.